Brooke's able to see my agenda. Awesome. All right. So we'll go ahead and get started, and folks could join in as we move along here. But yeah, this welcome to the workforce cross-cutting meeting. This meeting follows prior meeting that's made up of folks that are working through these workforce cross-cutting issues and the update to the climate action plan. There was some pre-work done prior to this meeting. I think Kara and Jane maybe had worked on some workforce issues to make some revisions that we'll look at today. But just to give an overview of the agenda, we'll be reviewing those recommendations and revisions within the template, and just kind of going through and for folks that didn't do this pre-work to see the changes that were made, see if anyone has any thoughts or comments or questions, confirm that we're good with the recommendation, and then move on to the next one. And then we will be looking to prioritize recommendations. I did add some columns that kind of hits on cost effectiveness, impact, and other measures that allow for the prioritization process that only is applied to new actions for this update, not existing ones. And then finally, we'll lift up three recommendations in total, so three actions that I'll present to the council on December 16th. This doesn't mean that the other recommendations are going away. It's just like, what are we presenting as the top three priorities that we want to share with the Climate Council on December 16th. After that, we'll move to public comment, and then we'll wrap up and go through next steps, which I think hopefully at that point, if we get through everything, is just me presenting at the Climate Council meeting with this work and these priorities that was worked on from this group. And then we'll wrap up. Any questions on the agenda? All right, cool. I will then move to sharing the Excel template. Okay. So these are what we have here. I just want to show folks is the new columns I added for priorities. But essentially, we have strategies related to the U.S. Climate Alliance, and we'll go through each one, just giving an overview of what's here. And it looks like some new strategies and actions that were added since our last meeting. And so that's what we're going to go through today. Okay. And it looks like, okay. So,
Liz, can you make that a little bigger?
yeah.
Thank you.
Yep. And I'm also going to throw this link in the chat too, in case that's helpful.
Yeah, that'd be great. Thank you.
Is this better? Folks can see.
Yes, thank you.
Awesome. Here, I'm not sure which ones you did, or Jane's online. Awesome. Jane, we're just going starting to look at the template. And we're gonna walk through the ones that have been added here. Just see if confirm if folks are good with any changes, have any questions, comments, and then after that we'll kind of go through the prioritization of them. So this first one is a new strategy related to the U.S. Climate Alliance. Advance the U.S. Climate Alliance's governor's climate ready workforce initiative in service of building workforce needed to drive climate action in Vermont. And then you'll see here there's four actions that fall under it. The first two are new. So I just want to give folks a moment to read those two, and then I'm going to ask if there's any comments, questions on these revisions, or if folks are good with those two. Yeah, Jane.
Morning, everyone. Sorry to be late. That first one, and I take fault for this since I was the one who wrote these actions. We should say, and that it's sort of misrepresented the 1 million new registered apprenticeships. It makes it look like we're going to have those all in Vermont, which, while impressive, would be impossible. We'd also have to like quadruple our population. So I would say strengthen workforce diversity, and then instead of and train, maybe say in service of collective alliance goal of 1 million new registered apprenticeships. And then it already says it across 24 alliance states.
Do you, Jane, want to say U.S. Climate Alliance, just so people are aware of?
Yeah, that would be great, Joey. Thank you. I'm still like, I wonder if there's a way, like through this process, like to figure out what a reasonable Vermont contribution is. And I think that's a question that comes up a lot. And like, I'd love to continue to talk about with Department of Labor, like what feels like a Vermont contribution to this. Anyway, I don't know if we want to say anything about this, but that. And sorry, since I'm late and talking now, I'm just going to say a couple things. Kara and her group team did a really nice job of drafting the act, like revising and drafting the actions that are sort of after the ones related to the governor's climate workforce ready initiative. And I still want to think about with you all if that's a different strategy, do they fall under? Like, is there a way to lump a little bit, or should we split further? That I think that would be helpful as we read it, just to make sure. Just because it's under this strategy of the governor initiative doesn't mean that it can't be other things, or just how to represent it correctly. And then my final thing I'll say before I stop talking is just that even though I was also late, I have to switch to my phone to transition to the office in like 10 minutes, but thanks.
Jane, can you make that final point again, though? Sorry, I just wasn't.
Yeah, so maybe let's look at the strategies first and then look at the specific actions, because it's all one pathway. Is that right now, Liz? I haven't spent enough time with as much time as I should have before this meeting with the whole thing.
Yeah, it's now all under that one pathway of 27. It was, which I'm trying to clean this up. I realize I hit and delete, so I need to unhide that. But it will now be under one pathway.
So it's one pathway about workforce development. And then there's two or three strategies?
Three.
Yeah.
Nope, four.
Okay. Maybe we should let's just look at the strategy level first.
Okay. Yep.
And then look at the action. So this is the first strategy, which has to do with the governor's climate workforce initiative, which is, again, a collective action across the 24 states. We get financial and technical assistance support around this. And it's very specific to apprenticeships targets, but then it has these sort of squishier goals around sectors that don't give targets. So resilience, clean energy, and manufacturing. And then it also has, a component around equity and very specific to women, honestly, because women are very much left out of these kinds of jobs. So those are sort of the squishier statements in the governor's initiative. And then we could look at the other strategies, which were really supported by, thank you very much, Cara and her team, which was great from the EAN workforce group.
This is the next one.
Yeah.
Sorry, was that me?
Oh no, you're all set, Billy. It seems like a separate strategy to me. If we go to the next one, Liz, I wanted to read the strategies first and then create a supportive environment. Last, there's one more, right? Great. These feel like separate strategies. The third one I might ask us to talk a little bit about as at the strategy level first, because strategies are supposed to be measurable. Like the pathways, the what, the strategies, a measurable, should be somehow measurable as a goal. This feels like something we want to do for sure. And it speaks to sort of like, I guess I'd be curious, Cara, what you think of. It kind of speaks to the fact that we're transitioning into a space where like tech jobs and trade jobs are, we're trying to make them feel more glamorous and supported than they were maybe in the past. But I'd be curious what you meant by that specifically, and if it can be couched under other things, or if how to do that, like in a way.
So the difference between the strategy three and strategy four, where strategy three was really about how do we support people who are in the state now to step into these jobs and have more current Vermonters in those jobs. And then strategy four went a little broader and longer term, which was more like how do we help more youth and potentially people coming from out of state to fill those workforce needs. And that's how I heard it from the full group of people who were working on these.
That's
And they were
great.
originally drafted as that being the pathway. And so
Yeah.
I think that it does need a little more precision because it's
Yeah.
at the
Now it's
strategy
true.
level now.
Well, these, let's go through them one by one then, because it does feel like they all warrant being separate strategies, even if we want to fine-tune the language. Makes sense to me.
So this is the first one, and we'll start. We already looked at action one, so we'll start with action two, but this is the first strategy.
I'm good with that one. Others are. One drop down list to action three, unless people have questions.
So action three and action four, those were already existing in the prior, but got moved to be within this.
Yeah, I don't action. I'd like to run action three by DOL. Is anyone from DOL on the call?
I'm here. I'm traveling, so I'm
Oh yeah.
just yeah.
It's hard to, it's probably hard to read then.
Could
Yeah.
you read that for
Sure.
action three?
Action three. Okay, yeah. So action three says focus registered apprenticeship outreach and program development on specific occupations, weatherization specialist, electrician, plumber, solar installer, and invest state and federal funds in offsetting wages so employers have an incentive to safely take on additional apprentice training spots.
We are doing some of that, particularly with electricians and plumbers. I think we're going to need to access, probably look for some state funding opportunities when it comes to offsetting wages. I mean, we do have, you know, we do have our core set of Workforce Innovation Opportunity Act funds, which can help support people entering the field in the form of on-the-job training funds. But when it comes to like specific wage offsets for like the broader population, we probably will need to look for federal funding opportunities to support that work.
So, I mean, so it sounds like some of it is happening. So some of it's advancing. I mean, I wonder if, would it make sense to have another action then related to like sustaining funding for like separating this out a bit, if some of this is happening and some of it isn't, in terms of like the apprenticeship outreach and such, but not having funding for the offsetting wages.
I don't think it requires a separate action.
Yeah.
Okay.
But maybe the language, like instead of invest state and federal funds, it's like invest and seek out or something additional.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
That would be great. Yeah.
Thank you, Cindy.
And would you categorize the status of advancing then?
Yeah.
All right. And for the first one, we didn't do the status. Actually, the first two, we didn't do the status.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're both advancing.
All right. Anything on action four?
We're working on that. Our apprenticeship director, so that's definitely advancing, is actively engaged in attending electrical and plumbing licensing board meetings.
Okay, thanks. Okay, so then we're moving to action one of the second strategy.
Is that second sentence like an action of the first sentence in the strategy, meaning like speed adoption of cost and energy saving with devil or like should it say like to speed adoption of cost, like increased capacity and productivity within the current contractor network to speed adoption of cost and energy saving technologies? Okay. Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah. No, the instead of a period after, yeah, there. There you
Is it okay if I talk, or do you want me to wait until the public comment period?
No, I feel like you're just part of the team, Kara. I keep calling on you anyway. We could do this without you. Help.
I mean, I feel like action one and two could be combined here. And then I think there's a need for a little bit more definition around who's doing this. Some of this is happening. And I think The problem is that not enough of it is happening. Vermont Sustainable Jobs Fund is doing some of this in terms of HR and training support. Vermont Works for Women. Like, there's various groups that are doing it, but I think maybe this is about having additional funds and opportunities for these sorts of activities.
So combine potentially combining those first two actions
Yes,
we
so like
okay.
they help, and then just put at the end to train, retraining employers to understand and support. And then maybe the other action is like, I don't know, I'm trying to think about how, like, or maybe instead of help businesses, it's like, it's the who, like, how do we,
Is it identify? Like, do we need to do the work of identifying, like, who needs the support?
Yeah, well, and I'm just trying, like, Vermont Business for Social Responsibility and others that Carr was just referring to, it's like, how do we get them,
Oh.
how does the state partner with them and others, which I'm sure is happening and getting funding, but more of it. Maybe it's
Like
enough just to say it like that. I don't know.
strengthen partnerships.
Yeah, I like that.
Something like that. Okay.
What if it was business expansion instead of businesses to expand? Well,
Yeah,
no.
just oh yeah, oh yeah.
In
Say
nature.
expansion of
Yeah.
So strength partners to expand.
so to support business expansion of HR training and support. Just said, like, to train employers in an effort to increase success in recruitment and retention or something. Like, maybe the diverse, even though I support that, maybe it's not needed there.
No.
Yeah, I think that's fine.
Now you get rid of two.
That looks good. Okay, so let's move on to the next action two and three. Oh wait, no, we're moving action two because that went up to one. So action three.
That's quite different. And I think it stands alone.
Us on action
Awesome.
three.
Awesome.
I'll move to action one of the next strategy.
Again, I could see action one and two combined. Action two is kind of a subcategory of the workers who would be supported in action one, if we're
Okay.
trying to combine things.
Yeah. Anyone else on the new action one combined with two?
That works for me. I want to, I'm in my mind still mulling over the language of the strategy. I want it to be a little less squishy, I
As
guess is the
more
word.
concrete,
Yeah. If
it
anybody
could be
has ideas.
something. If you want measurable, it could be increase. Well, this is the whole thing, increase the number of people in these jobs. It's draw new workers into these jobs from people who are among the people who are
Yeah.
already in the state. It's that something like that.
Yeah. Like focus targeted. I want to say something like about a campaign about like about Vermonters. So like focus targeted outreach training support to Vermonters to increase employment in these fields or something like that.
One language thing I've been hearing is some people don't hear Vermonters and think that we mean people who've been
Oh.
here for a long time. We want to include new Americans, like everyone who's already here.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, good. Yeah. So people living in Vermont?
Yeah, I think
Okay.
so. Residents.
Yeah. Residents. That sounds pretty safe.
Something like that. Target outreach for existing Vermont residents to enter and stay in these fields.
Yeah, something like target focus, well, target outreach and support. Like I don't know, like something beyond outreach, target outreach and target outreach, comma, training and I don't know, support systems for yeah, something like that. I'm not sure if it's
Maybe it should be
support
like
systems.
retention. I
Think
well,
support
yeah.
systems are good because
Okay.
it's a little beyond just retention. It's
Yeah. Is everyone okay with these fields, or do you want to like keep it broad or be more specific?
I missed that, Liz.
There's the last parts and stay in these fields. Do you want to keep it broad like that, or do you want to get more specific?
It maybe to enter and stay in
Yeah, is there anything
climate. Yeah.
getting people in? Yeah. I like that, to enter and stay in climate and clean energy jobs, fields.
Jobs is good.
Careers. Oh, career is perfect.
Careers, love it.
So this one is things like server and learn and those sorts of programs. Resource. And I wonder if it should be service dash to dash career options, if that makes it clearer or if it's not necessary.
Oh.
I feel like the term pre-apprenticeship might be important to include somewhere in one of these actions, and it might be able to be part of number three, continue to grow and support service to career, pre-apprenticeship and pre-apprenticeship options.
I got opportunities. Okay.
Not to make it too complex, but another term that I'm hearing a lot is earn and learn. Because I think some people are finding apprenticeship to be a little bit too much to tackle in some ways. And until we get that broken down, I think the term earn and learn, so just things like internships and work experiences and job shadows and those kinds of opportunities. So maybe continue to grow and support service to career options. Yeah, that's it.
Awesome. Anyone else on this third action?
I think you want to replace the, you want service to career options, comma, pre-apprenticeship, comma, and earn and learn
Oh, yeah.
opportunities.
Thank you.
I mean, I will defer to Cindy and others, but is it continue to grow and support strategies such as service to learn, pre-apprenticeship, earn and learn up, et cetera? I mean, are there other, it's those are just, I don't know. Could it potentially be broader than those service to career opportunity? Does that capture everything, I guess is my question.
I think that's a good suggestion, Joey, to make it broader.
Just to continue to grow and support workforce strategies such as service to career options, comma, pre-apprenticeships, earn and learn opportunities, et cetera. I don't know. I defer to you, Cindy.
I mean, there may be a few others, and the language is what will people will, kind of jump on with, but such as helps to give people a framework, I think. There's a, I don't think
That
this
it's,
is exhaustive.
yeah, it's encompassing, but not, yeah, exhaustive or exclusive of other op so, okay. That looks great.
Can I just jump in with something for a second? So I'm a little concerned that I don't see anywhere in these three or four strategies any reference to farm or forestry related occupations. I think that's why Ag and Ecos was invited to participate in this, because there were a number of actions we had related to supporting our working farm and forest managers, given their important role in helping to mitigate the effects of climate change through carbon storage and sequestration. So, I understand the focus on the trades, but would just put out to the group the question as to whether we should try to build in at least an acknowledgement of the workforce challenges and opportunities in farm and forestry.
I think the ones that we could definitely add in language, the ones that were existing, I believe are still with Ag and Eco.
Okay.
Yeah, like they're not lost. And I think they were actually originally in education and then not workforce, but then we decided it would make more sense for just Ag and Eco because that's where the expertise is on like what those actual programs are. But we could definitely add like inherent language that also make sure it's inclusive of that.
Yeah, I guess I'd be
Yeah.
curious. Like, I, Billy, it was like you were reading my mind because it was like just hitting me at that same time you brought that up. I'd be curious if Cindy could talk to, and I like this feels very focused on like this registered apprenticeships, training, support systems, how and where the state has done that in the past, and if that has occurred outside of like
the ag agency and or FPR and other spaces. Like, I just don't like know in my mind like where that work lives. And maybe it's like a good idea to think about like it by the implementer and where those support systems are about how we build it within the plan.
Well, we would support our funding can support training opportunities in the ag and forest, in those roles. I don't think we traditionally have, but that doesn't, mean we couldn't do that with our federal training dollars. I think when you get to apprenticeship in some of those occupations, it does get more challenging, but the federal government provides a extensive list of apprenticeable occupations, and I can certainly do some research to find out. And I mean, we do have some flexibility as a state apprenticeship agency to create apprenticeship pathways in most occupations, as long as all the components of an apprenticeship are present. So I don't know if that answered your question. We the Department of Labor, have the ability to support job training and career development in those sectors.
I mean, I think it would be really great to figure out a way to do that. Sorry if I just cut you off. I can't see very well, Julie. I do feel like with the governor's focus and interest in sort of leading the resilience component of the work, those jobs are really critical. So if this provides an opportunity for us to expand our thinking about what apprenticeships looks like and how we access and use federal funds around farm and forestry, that feels like a win to me.
Agree.
I agree.
Great. So yeah, I'm that all sounds good to me. I don't know that we need to resolve this this second, but if there's a way to just try to work that acknowledgement or those fields into this in a way that makes sense, that would be great. That would address my comments.
So would we want to go back to the strategy and enter and stay in? Is there a way to add that language in what we've climate, clean energy, careers? Is there a way to add?
I like that idea.
Add agriculture in there. How does that look?
Well, I think it should be more
Farm
like
and
somehow,
forestry.
yeah, farm and forestry or natural and working lands or
Natural.
resilience.
Yeah. I mean, not to overplay it, but you could also just take out the and just to say et cetera. I mean, just again, this is not exhaustive, probably, but these are the big buckets. I don't know.
You mean take out clean energy?
No. Like just to
Oh.
say to enter and stay in climate, farm and forestry, comma, clean energy and other clean energy or in resilience careers, just to try and, and other clean energy and resilience careers. I don't know.
You could also just do stay in climate careers such as farm and forestry and clean energy.
Oh, sure, something like
Either
that.
way, it's fine.
Yep.
I
That's
like
probably
that.
tidier. That's tidier.
Thank you for indulging me.
Thanks for raising it, William. William's iPhone speaking up.
That's right.
That's right. What, you can't get on camera? You're not prettified yet? Come on,
I
Billy.
had to walk the dog. I was at a board retreat for the last 50 hours, so I'm a little behind today with life.
Oh man. Well, thanks for bringing it.
Okay, so how's that provision for everyone?
I don't think you need other.
Oh, thanks.
Such as farm and forestry.
Clean energy.
And resilience. Yeah, that looks great.
Awesome. Okay. Is there anything else that we've already, I mean, to include for like agriculture, for farm and forest, aside from the strategy, or think that kind of captures?
I guess wherever we reference like sector-like jobs, if we say climate or clean energy in other places, we would just probably want to be inclusive if possible. So maybe we could just do it once over and check after.
Yeah, I'll do that. Okay. Okay, so then let's do the strategy, which is the final strategy and actions.
And again, this was in the group that drafted this, this was meant to be sort of that longer, how do we create the on-ramp for youth? How do we create the on-ramp for people who might not be in the state right now? It's fine if that changes, but just to give you that, because I'm not sure that the language is that precise.
That's great. And that should just probably, as we walk through it, Liz, just to be mindful of like, there is an education. I don't know what those are looking like, those recommendations, but it would probably intersect in some way with whatever's here, just if we're thinking about that long career ramp up.
Also, just knowing that we're at public comment time, I don't think there's any other. Carol, you've been kind of being able to talk throughout. I don't think anyone else, but just want to note that. Yeah, I'm not seeing anyone else, so we can continue on. So, at the action level, any comments?
I do think it'll be interesting to compare this with the education and just decide which bucket some of these things live in. But some of them we've heard a lot of, you know, like there's not enough trainers. It'd be good if somewhere in this plan, whether it's here or in education, that gets addressed, I think. Although I would bow to Cindy's greater knowledge on this work.
Yeah, there are some education recommendations that feel similar. Especially with the like the career technical centers, there's definitely one recommend like at an action level that talks about that. I don't think it hurts to have it in here as well, but I mean I'd be happy like following this meeting as a follow-up to just like kind of share with that so people could see it, share what that recommendation is in the education.
I just wondered if the strategy, just to kind of keep the language consistent, wouldn't want to be create a full, clear career pathway and then bring down from the previous strategy for who, the who part that we just worked on.
Okay. You're talking about the climate careers? Okay. How's that revision? I added to support climate careers such as.
I think it's great. I just think it's really consistent and it keeps those that language.
I might add potential workers in climate careers. I think this is about the workers. So to support potential workers in climate careers, maybe.
I don't know if we need the parentheses for longer term. Yeah. Now that, I mean.
And maybe some places here you want to add some agricultural or working lands language as well. Like we specifically had called out electrician, plumbing and building trades, HVAC, electrical, weatherization. I'm sure, and I don't know what all the apprenticeships are, but there's probably some additional things that could be listed there.
Well, there are also action number three. And again, this kind of blends into the education side, but yeah, there's certainly agricultural and natural resources programs in CTE centers around the state as well.
As I added in agricultural and working land, agriculture and working land sectors.
And maybe it's again a qualifier like supported in the career and tech ed system in the state, especially in or in sectors such as, you know, something that makes it so that it isn't just those.
Yeah. State. Group. I'm going to scroll down so you can see the rest of the actions here. We'll do any comments for these last three, and then we're actually almost at time, so we'll kind of go over our next steps.
It feels to me like action five could actually be moved up a strategy, the supporting people starting and building their own businesses, or it could stay where it is, but fits in either place maybe.
Are you proposing action five could be its own strategy?
No, that it could be either part of the strategy it's in or the strategy above, where we talk about supporting the development of employers.
Yeah, would that make more sense, do you think? What do folks think about moving that? Thumbs up. Cindy, you're on mute, maybe. I can't.
It seems like it could go in both places. I mean, if the strategy above is about supporting the people who are in Vermont, our current residents, and then this is the creating more of the pipeline development, but all of that should address the opportunity and support the opportunity for self-employment and people having their own business. So maybe it's an action that
I like that better. Them. Sorry. Yeah.
So maybe leave it where it is for now.
Okay. Any other comments? And then, if not, we'll talk about just next steps with the remaining time. So the pieces that, this is great. The pieces that we are still remaining are the prioritization process for the new actions in terms of like identifying high, medium, low for cost effectiveness, co-benefits and impact, technical feasibility. I wonder if that could be some follow-up work afterwards to do that, and I can share that out, Jane.
Well, I guess I'd be curious what like Joey, Billy, people who are really involved in the council stuff, but I kind of struggle with the prioritization for these broader pathways that are sort of enabling pathways, aka cross-cutting. So I kind of feel like the work is that we have this nice list for these. I'm not sure how you're dealing with this, Liz, and other groups, but I'm okay with like this goes now to the council along with sort of the suite of priority actions that the subcommittees are lifting up across their broader list. And then we sort of ask the council how and where they want to prioritize these cross-cutting issues, knowing that like without them, nothing sort of happens. So I'm okay with just having the neat and tidy list and focusing the review and prioritization of them with the council, because it's a bigger question about where and how they fit across the full body of work.
Yeah, I think that makes sense. And what we did with education is that I asked, because we only had like one new action to do the high, medium, low prioritization with, was to, I asked the group to send me out of the ones that we reviewed in our meeting time and revised, send me like what they think the top three should be that we present with the council meeting at the December 16th. So that could be something just out of all of these. Like what are the top three in your mind that you think would be worth sharing in that meeting time to lift up to the council?
I like that. If people on this call are willing to do that, I think that would be good and see if there's some consensus across it.
That's fine with me. And I apologize, I got to jump. So thanks, everyone.
Thanks.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Okay. Great. Yeah, so that sounds good. I'll send a follow-up email just asking for just recapping our next steps and asking for folks to send me the top three. And I'll share out like a PDF version of this as well, just because I know that not everyone has access to this template. And then from there, we do have this refined list now. So thank you for your work. And that would be then our last meeting with this group.
Yeah, what I was going to say, Liz, is it'd be nice maybe with all of these, like, I know that we need to be able to document the changes we made. So have this list that we have that shows all the edits, deletions, et cetera, but then just make a clean list with the final cleaned up, perfect, the actions. And that would help people be able to see. What
I'll make a
from.
New tab. That's just like a new clean version. I'll make that the PDF.
Great.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Thank you.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much, everyone. And this is great. So I'll be in touch via email and have a great day.
Yeah, thank you, everybody. This was helpful.
Thank you.
Okay. Have a good one. Bye.